We're here at the Intermountain Bird Observatory's new Boise River Research Station, and it's located just upstream from the Barber Pool area. It makes for a really great research site because it's one of the last undeveloped riparian corridors along the Boise River. And we're looking forward to not only using this property and preventing it from being developed, but also using it as an example of how humans and nature can coexist. The Intermountain Bird Observatory is a nonprofit research branch of Boise State, and our mission is to combine real research science and monitoring, and we're combining that science and monitoring with outreach and education. Our pie in the sky dream for this site is to eventually have an actual building, so an actual education center where we can base our operation out of, so it's really accessible, close to town for public schools, private schools, anybody who wants to come and visit.
Every year I've brought at least one group of students up to Lucky Peak for an overnight field trip. So they've not only gotten to see the songbird banding happen in the morning and get to hold songbirds in their own hands, but students get to stay up all night and watch owl trapping happen and then hang out in the afternoon and do hawk trapping too. So I think it's helped them appreciate how much diversity there is in the bird community locally and spend some time outdoors that they otherwise wouldn't.
So now that his band's on, he has a unique band number that no other bird in the world will have. So it's a unique identifier, and it's a permanent marker. I think the first thing that happens when field trips arrive is they don't really know what to expect. They've maybe not even heard about bird banding before, so it's fun to sort of explain, you know, it's like a bracelet, and we're tagging these birds, and we're going to track them for their whole life. As soon as you put that bird on their hand and it flies away, they're like, can I do another one? And you see that click. You know, they're so excited, and they kind of realize this new connection with nature that maybe they weren't that excited about before. And now, you know, they care.